Hey folks, the video you're about to see is a real short hunt that I had with my niece, Sydney. It's not a very long hunt, but it's one that means the world to me. You know, one of the greatest things about owning a hunting property is getting to share it with family and friends. And I was with Sydney when she shot her very first buck. And it's quite the story because I wasn't sure we was gonna get that buck on the ground, but take a look.
So I am Sydney Boehm. I am Don Higgins' niece. So I'm actually from Southern Illinois, but currently I'm living in Kansas.
Of all my nieces and nephews, I probably have more in common with Sydney than any of them. Anytime we get together for family gatherings, her and I are always talking about livestock or deer hunting or whatever.
Started bow hunting probably about 3 or 4 years ago. Uncle Don helped me get my bow and everything and helped me get set up and has taught me the fundamentals of that.
She had said that she'd been deer hunting but hadn't seen much all season, and I'd already shot a couple of deer and had plenty of bucks on my place, and I thought, well, I can show her a deer pretty easy. So I invited her out, and it just so happened that this was a really cold spell in November during the rut.
So it was cold, and I'm a little person, so I get cold easily anyway, so I'm never warm.
And we're sitting there overlooking this plot of real world soybeans. And I looked down the way and I seen a deer feeding, but it had its head down, and I couldn't tell if it was a buck or a doe. It was probably 100 yards from us, actually. And then it raised its head, and Sid says, "That's a buck." And I got my binoculars out, and I can tell, yeah, that was a pretty good one.
I see how wide he is, and he was pretty much up and straight out and wide and super pretty and looked right at me. And my heart, I've never felt my heart beat so fast in my entire life. I just got the shakes. Like, I've heard people talk about the shakes, but I never had them. So these are my first experiences. Oh, I was losing my mind. I was trying to get an arrow notched, and Uncle Todd is trying to get the camera ready, and the camera's shaking everywhere. And
we sat there, and the deer, you know, slowly worked its way towards where we was waiting in the blind, fed along the in the soybeans right towards us, and it comes up and in range, and you know, I tell Sid, "Get ready," and she's standing up in the blind. She's got her release on the string, and she's ready to pull back, and this buck cuts across right in front of us broadside and stops, and I'm filming, you know, I've got the video camera on this buck, and I can hear Sid right beside me and catch her out of the corner of my eye. She couldn't get her bow back. She was sitting there struggling. And
I can't get my bow back.
I was so nervous and cold and bundled up, I couldn't get my bow pulled back. And I was so embarrassed and heartbroken because I knew that this deer was just gonna bolt away and I was just gonna probably end up hating my life for the rest of the day. But I tried to pull my bow back. I'm pretty sure I pulled it back once and then I was too weak and it let loose once. But then I was like, you know what? He's still standing there. He's still looking at me. If I don't pull back one more time, I'm gonna hate myself.
So I'm turning, I don't know whether to keep filming this buck or to turn or to set the camera down and help her get the string back. And finally, she pointed it towards the sky and she got her back and she settled down. So I focused back on the deer, and I thought, as I'm sitting there filming, I'm thinking, there's no way she's hitting this deer. She can barely get the bow back, and there's no way she's gonna hit it. I'm thinking, I'm getting ready to film this arrow sail 3 feet over this buck's back.
So I pulled back one more time and I put my pin on him, put it right behind his shoulder, and I just let it loose because he was looking right at me and he was gonna bust me probably, so I just let it loose.
I hear release the arrow and I see that buck duck, and I heard the arrow hit home, so I knew she hit it. And he took off on a death run down along the edge of the soybeans, and he cut back into the real world switchgrass. And I could see him running through that switchgrass for a little bit, and then it just stopped. And I thought, he piled up right there.
When I finally realized that he's out there in that switchgrass and he's down, I was ready to get back out there. I was like, when are we going out? When are we going out? When are we going out? And Uncle Don's like, give it some time.
It was pretty gratifying to see her shoot her first buck.
It's been a good day.